Okay, I'll call the meeting back to order. In accordance with the open meeting law, the board states for the record that this meeting is being recorded by NORCAM and may be recorded by other local media. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to welcome our guests here this evening and those that are watching on cable. The first item on our agenda is to recognize Bob Toros from the transcript. Sad news is he's retiring. That's good news too, but maybe sad for us. So we have a presentation to make to you. I think there may be more than one. If you could come forward, Bob.
By the way, we need someone to take a picture of this. We have to. Bob, can you do a selfie?
Is there someone here with a camera?
Yeah. Here's a camera.
Okay.
Oh, it's nice.
Very good. So I'm going to read it. This is presented to Bob Toros on behalf of the town of North Reading in recognition and appreciation of 40 years of exceptional reporting and coverage of town news and events for the North Reading Transcript, given by the Board of Selectmen December 5th, 2016.
Thank you.
We wish the very best at any time.
Do you want to get a little closer and get a picture?
Yes. That's good. Can you get all of us in? Okay.
Jane? Yes.
Yeah, Jane. Definitely.
Absolutely.
You can shake your hand. You can shake your hand, Bob. Okay.
All set?
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's beautiful.
Congratulations.
Don't go anywhere. We have another presentation. I will. So the town clerk, Barbara Statz, could not join us this evening because of her previously scheduled trip. So she's out of state, as I understand it, not able to be here this evening. Very disappointed that she could not be here to recognize you, because I know she has worked very closely with you over a number of years. So first I'll point out she made this wonderful banner. I'm sure you recognize the setup. We've got it up on our new technology here, and the original is right underneath the cake.
Recognize the photos. She took them. Memorial day.
She told me. So we have a wonderful setup here, and we have a lovely cake over there as well that Mr. Briscoe brought this evening. So thank you, Mr. Briscoe.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
And I have a presentation. First, there were a couple that I provided you that are our gifts privately for you to say thank you. And I have one public here that I'm going to read out loud, if you don't mind.
Sure.
Thank you. So again, reading this on behalf of the town clerk, it says, Robert Bob Toros, North Reading Transcript, is hereby granted indefinite status as honorary town meeting visitor with freedom of the floor privileges. And there's a copy of the traditional black label that Bob would wear when being admitted to the floor here. I'll read the bottom. I hereunto set my hand and affix the seal of that said town of North Reading this 5th day of December 2016, signed by Barbara Statz, town clerk. So,
yes, please.
So if you feel the need to wean yourself off, you can come back to
And Bob, on your usual chair, there were some cookies. I don't know where they ended up.
I said they're right there.
I've got my eye on them.
They're not looking at me.
Those cookies were baked for my wife. Every year, Bob manages to get his own little tray of cookies. And when I told my wife that tonight was the night, she had to start cooking, doing Christmas cookies quite a bit earlier than she normally does. Oh. So those are just for you. Board members, we will have cookies at our next meeting.
Are we going to be putting the chair into the museum? We should retire the chair.
You may
want to take it home.
My back will never recover from that chair.
We got to save the chair. We'll send it up to the entertainment tavern.
Thank you all. I mean, it's amazing. Everything looks different up here. From up here, all of a sudden, I feel like making a speech. Must be something about the table.
You're welcome.
I want to thank the board very much, because this means a lot to me, coming from the Board of Selectmen. I know how hard you work, and it's not an easy job, and I know how many hours you put in. Most people think being on the Selectmen or school committee, you meet a couple of times a month for a couple of hours, and then you go home. But I know that but Selectmen, School Committee, Finance Committee, Planning Commission, all of these jobs require untold hours of work, nights, weekends, on subcommittees, you know, Saturdays, all those things, and the phone calls. I can't imagine the phone calls you all get. I don't know how you stand it. You know, it's I know it's because a true labor of love and because you want the best for North Reading. And I really respect that, and that makes this all the more important to me. So thank you very much.
Thank you for your kind words.
So, you know, sadly, a lot of the people I first met when I first came to North Reading over 40 years ago are no longer with us for various reasons, but two of them are. Bob Messeri and Steve O'Leary were two of the first people I met when I came to North Reading back in the 70s. Bob was on the school committee at the time. He was an engineer, of course, and he used to, as they used to do in those days, he wore his a calculator on his belt every night when he came to the school committee meetings. You should have seen it. The thing was the size of a microwave. And he introduced the school committee to the trying to make the choice between needs, wants, and dreams when it came to budget time. He used to write it on the bulletin board, and I still remember that. Steve was the youngest town moderator in the state at 19. Didn't have a gray hair in his head at the time.
And neither, I couldn't grow a
beard. And neither did I. But I've known you and your family for all these years, and it's been one of the highlights of my life, and I really appreciate everything. Mike Prisco, Kate, and Jeff, I haven't known you nearly as long as some of the others, but I respect you every bit as much for the hard work you do and your good intentions and what all the extra work you do to make North Reading a better place. And the Board of Selectmen is a better place because of you. I saw Mike at Oliver last Friday night. It was the High School Masters production at the high school. It's a great show. And Mike came into the Performing Arts Center with a bouquet of flowers. Mike, I really thought the flowers were for me.
I wanted to, believe me. Deep in my heart, I wanted to do it. But I had to do the right thing for my daughter, who did a wonderful job. I'm so proud of her.
Michael Gilberto, you're my eighth town administrator. I think mentioned that to you numerous occasions. And it's just nice to see that North Reading finally has a keeper. But more than that, you're living proof that once in a while, even five blind squirrels can find an acorn. Thank you all very much. It's so nice to see so many of you here. And, you know, I've never lived here, but North Reading has always been more of a hometown to me than any place where I've ever actually slept. So again, thank you all very much. This is very touching, and I'm sure that nothing will change with the new editor, Bill LaForme, and I'm sure North Reading will continue to be the great community we all know it is and can be. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, one other thing. I'll be thinking of you all with budget season. But this year it's going to hurt you more than it will me.
Bob, I'll keep on working, trying to keep selling papers for you.
Too. Okay, yeah. Good job. You've been doing great so far.
7 years. I think I did pretty good for you.
Okay. At this point, I'll ask for a motion to go into recess.
Just a quick comment or two. That's all right. Just in relation to Bob, really, we're losing the sixth member of the board here. I don't know anybody, including all of us here, who has spent more time, more hours at meetings than Bob. I mean, talk about a selfless, individual because it's definitely a labor of love. He doesn't drive a fancy car. He doesn't spend a lot of money on stuff. So I mean, obviously, I don't think he's a. You know, I don't think he was really overpaid for what he did. And if you break it down to an hourly basis, he's poverty stricken. I mean, he probably came out to about 13 cents an hour. And but really, he spent more time at meetings than all of us because you know he's covered the select, he's covered the school, he covers the town meetings, he covers other meetings. It's just been unbelievable. He's been a one of the most tolerant individuals I've ever met in relation to covering town government. Been a gentleman the whole time. Obviously very patient. I mean, at times I think we noticed some looks of frustration from him. We actually took it. I don't know how we're going to do it. What's this guy, Bill? Looking forward to meet you. You've got to get some facial expressions. Plus a little bit of an indication like, you've got to be kidding me. We got lots of those. But commitment, understanding, but with his exiting here, talk about institutional knowledge leaving. I mean, there are many times when members of this board look to Bob and say, what did we do back then? What did we do before? And you go, you're doing it again? Or, yes, you did do that. Or, yes, it looks like you're going to do it again. But I mean, what we're losing here is a true member of the community. And, we wish you nothing but the best and a long, healthy, and happy retirement. Vicky, you'll enjoy him for a few months, and hopefully he doesn't wear on you too long. But you're going to have him home some evenings now.
Yeah.
My guess is your schedule's going to be a little bit messed up. A little bit. But enjoy him, because we certainly have for the last 40 years. And, nothing but the best.
Thank you.
Yeah. I was speaking to my wife Irene, and you know, I let her know that you were retiring, Bob. And the thing that she always noticed that you were everywhere in town. No matter where you turned, Bob Terose was there. It wasn't just at the meetings. There were many things, other things that he was doing. And I think, you know, if you're not in town anymore, I don't know what we're going to do. I mean,
he is over there.
Right. So, big shoes to fill, and I'm sure you will be able to do that. But I mean, he's just everywhere, and you're going to be missed. It's that simple. You're going to be missed. So, but have a wonderful retirement. Thanks. Enjoy yourself. You too.
Thank you all very much.
I have one.
Mine.
Yeah.
No, it's just one thing I was thinking about today on the way over here, that you really don't see little town newspapers stick around very long. But you know, you kept it around for a long time, even when it wasn't popular, even when it wasn't cost effective anymore, and I think that's a real big tribute to you. You should really be proud of that, because you know, throughout the country, it's really gone. You know, there's not many left, so thank you for doing that, because we don't have many ways of communicating with the public, and really through you, we were able to get that school done. Believe it or not, I know you don't want to take any credit for it, but you wrote really good articles that explained important things, like the police station, like the bat shelter, all those things. When you drive by, you should have a lot of pride, because I think a lot of those are there today because of the great writing and the way you captured what we were trying to accomplish. And so thank you. I appreciate it.
My memory is going to be looking over at you as the meeting has gone into well into the evening and seeing this. You know, stretch of your head, and then sometimes it does. You do this, but and also you take all these pictures of everything. So not only are you just capturing the story and the substance of the story, but we're seeing it visually through you. And I thank you for your commitment to the town, and big shoes to replace.
And the kindness that you've shown all of us. You were far
yes.
more generous than you needed to be. I know, myself included,
too
but
true.
For all of us, really,
yes.
you've done
yeah.
a great job and very fair.
Yeah.
Yes, Michael. Just as Bob is the sixth member of the Board of Selectmen, I know that there are a number of employees who are here this evening, some seated in the back row, some seated over the other side. And we felt that we worked alongside you, you know, and trying to advance the mission of the town. And, I know that they all feel the same way. That's why they're here this evening. So we'll certainly miss you day in and day out here in the town hall. We wish you good luck.
Thanks.
You're welcome. We welcome Bill.
Thank you all. Thanks,
Bob. With that, and Bob, thank you for the kind words. I'll ask for a motion to go into a recess so we can enjoy some
Chairman,
cake.
Chairman, I move that recess for 30 minutes.
Just move for a recess.
Move for a recess.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. All in favor?
Aye.
Unanimous. Get up and enjoy. Spend some time with Bob.
Well, I don't know. We should probably have a Tesla. She's from Revere. Malden.
We think about reconvening.
Oh, God. I love you. You are so lucky there.
Sure.
You're so lucky right now.
I guess so. Oh, my God.
We should have cake more often.
Yeah. You should need another retirement.
Well, we're going to have cookies next week.
Okay.
Okay, let's see. Jane is here. Where did Michael go?
That's funny. Jeez.
Bob, you're welcome to sit through the rest of the meeting.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of. I'll let Bill tell me all about it in the morning.
Yeah.
I get the feeling
you're
gonna
give up
came
the,
just for you.
You're going to give up the special chair?
There's the bell. So, you know.
Mm-hmm. Again, thank you very much, Bob.
Take care, Bob.
And good luck.
Thank you.
Bye, Bob.
Hope to see you around.
Good night. Thank you. Okay.
Where did Michael go?
Michael's right there.
All right, I'm going to call the meeting back to order. Next item on our agenda, is anyone here for public comment? Anyone here for public comment? No. Okay. We have the minutes of March 20.
Mr. Chairman, through you. I don't normally like to interrupt the meeting, but I know we have quite a bit of administrative work to do, and I believe Mr. Kogan is here with regard to town-owned land, particularly his parcel. And I don't know if we want to consider taking that item out of order.
Why not?
So through you, Mr. Chairman, and just for the record, this is item number 12. This is different from our normal annual review of town-owned land. Mr. Kogan has expressed previously at a meeting an interest in a parcel of land that's near his home. It is town-owned land that is, I believe, behind your home, and it abuts a paper street, if I'm not mistaken. I can report to the board that none of the town's departments responded expressing any use or desire to reuse this property for any other purpose. I believe it's undeveloped land that abuts your property and that you've expressed an interest relative to acquiring it for potential purposes of constructing an accessory building like a shed or a garage, but not for overall creation of an additional housing lot, if I understood your comments correctly. So we had advised Mr. Kogan that we would let him know the next time the board was going to bring up the discussion on town-owned land, which was 2 weeks ago. I think that you may have been here. If you weren't, we passed over the item effectively because we did not. It was late in the evening, that particular evening. The board, if it doesn't know, has a policy relative to the selling of town-owned land where it needs to convene a public process. This first discussion would perhaps be an opportunity for Mr. Kogan to express in his own words what the proposed request is, and then for the board to determine if it wants to continue the process with regard to conveying this land through the normal process prescribed under town bylaw and state law.
Would you come up to the, there's a mic right there. That they have. So tell us why you're interested in the land and what are your plans?
Again, I approached the committee once before, but my plans for the land are to make my lot somewhat more conforming. The back corner of my house right now is very close to the lot line because of the odd shape. I wish I had a map.
But so we have a lot. The board has a map showing the parcel.
We will provide a map, Mr. Chairman.
What page is it on? I'm seeing it. No?
It's towards the very back of the packet.
It's about four-fifths of the packet, four-fifths of the way down the packet.
So my intent is to purchase this piece of property from the town, and while I'm actually doing some work with my house now, and what I'd like to do is clear out some trees. It's a heavily wooded lot. Some concern over ticks and stuff like that, so we want to just clear some of that back. And I don't own that land right now, as it is town-owned land, so it would bring in a lot more sunlight to my home. So that's my ultimate goal.
Mr. Chairman, through you, there was a question that the first meeting that you were at relative to the status of Wadsworth as a public way, whether it was accepted by the town or not, and we've drawn a line in front of the property that shows that probably across 90% of your frontage at lot 76 in that area, I don't think that's your house address, but the lot is 76 on the assessor's map, probably 90% of your frontage is abutted by a public way, although I don't think it's paved to that extent. I think it's only paved in front of a portion of your property.
Just the front edge, yes.
Where your driveway is?
No, not even leading up to my driveway.
Okay. And there's another lot, 77, that's to, if I were looking at your property, to the right of your property, is that correct? It looks like it's got a house on it.
Left.
If you're, there is a small 5,000 square foot lot to the left of me if I walk out my front door, yes.
Okay.
That is on the paved section of road.
Okay. So those were questions the last time that the board had wanted us to get answers to. We do have those answers, and they're in the packet.
So is there actually a house on lot 77?
Yeah.
Yes, there is. There was some... Before I had moved to North Reading, I guess there was some disruption about developing that land, and I think it met the state requirement of 5,000. I think it's 5,250 square feet, which, interestingly enough, if I bought the piece of property from the town, which I believe is just under 4,000 square feet, I could try to section off part of the property behind his home, and because I effectively don't want to use it. It does me no good to have property directly behind someone's home.
Did I read in your letter that it's your intention to subdivide that and sell a portion to him? Is that the...
ultimately, in the end, I want to end up with a square lot, and one where I don't have to worry about being so close to a boundary line. And if, you know, I'm obviously going to be increasing my size lot, my tax burden will go up, but I mean, if I can also segment off a piece of that land, and I inquired that with my letter to the town administrator. It's not my intent to like skirt any rules, break any rules. I'm just trying to say, look, here's an opportunity I can end up with pretty much the same square footage, rough, maybe a small percentage, because I think the town piece of property is about 4,000 square feet, and if I really drew a line and sold the piece of property behind my neighbor's home, again, it's directly behind his home. It's not even behind mine. So I have approached them, and it's just been very... My thing is I want to get the town property first, get that secured, and then I can deal with the other piece.
Now, you mentioned something about the corner of your house is on the lot line or close to it?
No, I mean, my home is built within the regulations.
Yeah.
It's 25 feet, I believe, from the side setback.
But what's the closest... Is the... In the map we have, I don't know if the house is exactly placed on the lot.
No, he'd be closest to his neighbor, that's all.
Are you closest to your neighbor or closest to some other...
I'm probably equidistant, really,
okay.
Because the piece of property that I want to purchase from the town, I'm probably 25 feet from that, and then I'm on my garage side, I'm probably 25 feet to the neighbor's lot line.
Okay.
Oh, Wadsworth, okay.
So the main goal is to get kind of a nice square lot.
Yeah, and I can clear
and hopefully
out some
maybe sell
areas.
The other portion of the lot to your neighbor.
I mean, if
downstream, maybe if he's interested.
If it means sort of, I save some money in doing such, mm-hmm. Okay. We'd like to do that.
Okay. Board members, questions?
Oh, I think it's a good idea.
Yeah.
No objection.
So, Mr. Chairman, through you, if it were the pleasure of the board to continue with this, under the town's general bylaws, a sale of land, Chapter 5, Section 25, the board would initiate a process for the disposition of the land, which would call for a fair market valuation of the land and distributing notice to the Community Planning Commission, the Conservation Commission, School Finance, Recreation, and Housing Partnership Communities, as well as the Housing Authority, of the intention. And there's a 45-day review period that's triggered. And at the conclusion of that, there's a notice of sale that needs to be advertised in the newspaper for 2 consecutive weeks prior to the sale actually occurring. So there's a prescribed process. We'll just check that process against what the state law currently requires for us to pursue, because this was last updated, as I see it, in 1993.
So basically, do we have to go out to bid, or do we establish a value for the, how's that work?
But the first step is effectively to notify the involved departments.
Yeah.
Again, as I was saying, depending upon the value of this property, will trigger whether or not we have to talk about a competitive bidding scenario or not. It's tough to say right now.
Okay.
If we go through the competitive bidding process, if we have to go that way, we're not obligated to take the lowest price, are we?
The highest.
Oh, I mean the highest price. We're not obligated, are we?
No.
I don't believe that would be the case, but it would depend upon the nature of the procurement.
Go ahead, you finish. I mean, think historically, what we've tried to achieve here is to cover whatever costs are on the town to make this transfer, and that's it. But I believe we have to, there isn't a butter notice, right? You didn't say that, but isn't there an abutter notice?
I have to go through the details of the bylaw.
I just want the abutters to know that, just to be fair to them, because there is one abutter at lot 2, right?
Correct. I believe there's only one other abutter.
Yeah.
Yes.
So we just want to make sure that they are just aware of it.
I just noticed, and you are correct, there is an abutter notification within 7 days of the hearing.
But other than that, I mean, I know for myself, speaking only for myself, I would only be, at this point, I mean, I can't imagine 4,000 square feet. I mean, just, we should definitely cover our costs like we've done in previous times we've done this.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, I think this is, this request is fully in keeping with what the board's desire has been, to take some of these smaller parcels and get them back on the tax rolls to direct the abutters, to help them enhance their property, again, get it back on the tax rolls. And again, it's not a buildable lot. You know, as far as the restrictions we could put on it, it would not necessarily have to have the full restriction on there. We could have, you know, accessory buildings and uses and things like that. But it's fully in keeping with what our policy is, our revised policy has been, to just get the, at a minimum, the amount to cover the cost of the transfer and advertising, which has been somewhere between $1,000 and $1,200, I think.
Probably a little higher than that now, but yes.
Yeah. Whatever it is, and I think, you know, you can let the gentleman know what in the area what it's going to be, just so that you know what to bid as a minimum bid. But I think it's a good idea, and I wish more people would step forward looking to do the same thing.
Bob?
Yes.
Yeah, just a quick question. Just so I can understand the map a little bit better, I see Wadsworth. That's obviously, that's the road that's not town-owned, correct? Wadsworth?
It's not even complete, I think.
Wadsworth is a public way.
It's a public way. Thank you. I just
it's accepted by the town.
Now, I'm noticing that the plot lines on this, anyway, are showing a gap between, let's say, 79 and 77, and a gap between your property and 90 or 3. Is there a true gap there, or is that
The paper streets?
He's referring to paper
streets.
Those
are paper streets.
Those paper streets. Okay, thank you.
So arguably there may be frontage there. That's something that the Community Planning Commission will look at.
Right.
But there are paper streets that at one point were created by a subdivision to the rear of Mr. Cogan's property.
Oh, I believe you guys call it Acres Boulevard.
Yes.
What is it, Acres Boulevard?
Acres Boulevard.
Oh. You might want to turn your house around. That's a nice name.
It is.
Would you like to live in a boulevard?
The only house I think that would be nice.
Okay, so
can I just ask, can
model?
I have a quick, can I ask a quick question?
I'm sorry.
I was just wondering if, and I can't tell from just looking at this, but once you sort of squared off that parcel, could you subdivide it on that side to make a buildable lot? In
is
other
it
words,
big enough?
Yeah, would it be big enough?
No, he's not grandfathered. And where it's held in contiguous ownership, he would be grandfathered.
But could... Oh, so in other words, like making it...
And it's not an unaccepted way, it's on the boulevard.
So making it...
Sorry, is this discussion, I believe there's another town piece of property too as well, is that what you're talking about?
You mean, is that number three on this map?
That's town-owned land, yes, lot number three.
Because I mean, it almost looks big enough if you straighten off the neighbor lot, and he was interested, the one that's at 77, and then you just put a straight line down and you subdivided the other side. It almost looks big enough for a house. What's the...
But we would put a deed restriction on it though too, requiring him to make it part of his parcel and non-subdividable. That generally, that's what we do in our motions.
Okay.
Because if we're going to do that, we'd sell it as a buildable lot, get a lot more money.
Well, we would have to.
Yeah.
We would have to get the other side of
it. But we would actually, as part of our motion, require him to make it become part of his lot.
Okay.
And again, no. Sometimes we put no accessory buildings and no accessory use.
So
put a restriction on it, but. In this case, you know, if he wants to put a shed or a garage or something, that's fine.
Yeah, well, it would become his to do that. Would we, are we waiting until there's a declaration that it's surplus from the
it's up to us.
Planning, or it's, okay, so we can just vote now on that?
No, it's, we have a policy.
We start the process.
We have a policy that
yeah.
we follow, which runs through
right,
all the
right.
town departments and then.
Yeah, they'd have to value the land and all that so we'd know what the...
No, they also have to, again, validate that they don't need it. You know,
right,
said
right.
Or that they don't have a use for it.
Right, right, okay.
Any other questions, Catherine?
No, thank you.
So, Michael, do we need a motion?
I would ask the board to vote to initiate the process for the disposition of...
Lot. It says
lot,
one, is that...
Lot one on map 17.
So, Mr. Chairman, I'd move to initiate the sale process to Mr. Colgan of lot. Or
it's not to the specific.
I don't need to have to specifically to you, but okay. So,
yeah.
Move to initiate the sale process of lot one on map 17 off of Wadsworth Road.
Acres Boulevard.
And Acres Boulevard.
And Acres Boulevard.
And Acres Boulevard.
And Acres Boulevard.
Second by Mr. O'Leary. Through with discussion, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Someone will keep him informed of the progress.
Mr. Cohen, you'll receive a copy of the letter that we send to the involved town department, so you'll know where the status is and what the deadlines are. But this will take some time. It won't happen overnight. But you're on your way.
He'll be ready for the spring.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Okay, going back to minutes.
Bill, why don't you sit at the table, be comfortable.
March 28th and September 19th, we'll put it back on our executive session. We didn't have a full board. October 3rd executive session, I think it was just an update, Catherine, that you had on that. Did that get done for your satisfaction?
No. Oh,
sorry. That's for the next item. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to confuse you.
On March 28th?
No.
October 3rd.
October 3rd.
Hold on.
I thought it was you that hit.
Yes. Correct. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yes.
All right. I'll entertain a motion for the executive session.
Sorry.
October
I was still
3rd.
Writing up that last motion. So, all right.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Mr. Chairman, I move to approve the October 3rd, 2016 executive session minutes as written.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Okay. Vote to release the executive session minutes off. Town administrator has listed every single one of them. They were also put into Dropbox.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
So just to again clarify, we put copies of all the minutes in the Dropbox. There were a handful of scenarios where the redactions I think were so significant that it may not be appropriate to even go forward with the release. So I provided Selectwoman Manupelli with a revised motion crossing out a handful of the minutes that I don't quite think are ready.
Okay, so this is not up to date.
That's correct.
Okay.
I think we have a single motion for the release of the minutes as redacted. I think we could certainly vote it that way. I'm just noting that not all of the minutes on the agenda and in the initial motion are on the revised motion.
You want me to accepting the ones that were stricken from
sure.
further consideration?
Do we need to read all the dates at this point?
I guess potentially the board could consider voting it as printed on the agenda with the exception of the ones that are blacked out, but I'm not sure that you'll be able to read through the black marker. If you can read through the black marker, then we may be able to do it.
Sure. Want to do that?
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, I move to release the executive session minutes identified
on the agenda.
On the agenda as redacted, accepting the following: February 22nd, 2000, July 31st, 2000, September 5th, 2000, February 15th, 2011, March 7th, 2011, March 21st, 2011, January 5th, 2012, April 23rd, 2012, August 22nd, 2012, November 5th, 2012. January 28th, 2013. January 23rd, 2012.
It's 2013. It's a Scrivener's error.
Okay, 2013.
That's just a typo.
Okay, December 2nd, 2013. January 6th, 2011. January 27th.
Wait. That should be 2014.
14. Should be 14. 2014. Old lady eyes. January 27th, 2014. February 3rd, 2014. April 22nd, 2014. May 2nd, 2014. May 29th, 2014, to be redacted. October 21st, 2014. November 18th, 2014. December 8th, 2014. February 3rd, 2015. June 8th, 2015. July 13th, 2015. And August 24th, 2015.
So these are the ones that being
removed and not released.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Second. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. We have legal bills for October. Mrs. Manupelli, when you're ready.
Mr. Chairman, I move to approve legal bills for October 2016 in the amount of $11,356.93 as follows. Kopelman and Page PC General, $6,509.93. Kopelman and Page PC Labor, $4,847 for a total of $11,356.93.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? And now we begin license renewals. Are we going to circulate them as we go? Are we going to wait until after? What are we going to do?
Just
I believe they are all in the two sign folder with Selectwoman Manupelli, and that they can be circulated as we go along, you know, or afterwards, it's up to the board.
Okay. Mrs. Manupelli, you have a series of motions.
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following common victualler licenses to expire December 31st, 2017, subject to all regulatory department requirements. China Cuisine, Dunkin' Donut, Holy Donut, Dunkin' Donuts, No Reed Main OP LLC, Dunkin' Donuts, Shauna Donuts, Ginger Gourmet, Horseshoe Cafe, Inc., Kitty's Restaurant, Mario's Pizza and Subs, and Ryer's Store.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Next, we have common victualler all alcohol.
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following common victualler all alcohol licenses to expire December 31st, 2017, subject to all regulatory department requirements. China Cuisine, Ginger Gourmet Restaurant, Horseshoe Cafe, Inc., and Kitty's Restaurant.
Second.
Do you hear a second?
I said second.
Second by Mr. Yule. On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Next is common victualler wine and malt beverages. Mrs. Manupelli?
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following common victualler wine and malt beverage licenses to expire December 31st, 2017, subject to all regulatory department requirements. Mario's Pizza and Subs.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Next, we have package store all alcohol. Mrs. Manupelli.
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following package store all alcohol licenses to expire December 31st, 2017, subject to all regulatory department requirements. One Stop Liquors, New England Beverage and Redemption.
Second. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? Next, we have package store wine and malt beverage. Mrs. Manupelli.
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following package store wine and malt beverage license to expire December 31st, 2017, subject to all regulatory department requirements. Christopher's Market and Ryer's Store.
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous? We have next class one license, Mr. O'Leary.
I will be recusing myself, Mr. Chairman, on class one and class two car licenses because I have a family member who holds one and it may be a potential conflict of interest. So I will not be participating in any discussion or deliberations of the board, nor will I be voting.
Mrs. Manupelli.
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following class one licenses to expire January 1st, 2018, subject to all regulatory department requirements. Bobcat of Boston Incorporated, Brian Duchac, DBA National Sales, North Reading Motorsports, Melconi and Subaru.
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Yule. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Abstention?
Aye.
Next we have class two license. Mrs. Manupelli.
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following class two licenses to expire January 1st, 2018, subject to all regulatory department requirements.
Second.
A&J Motors.
Mr. Yule. She hadn't finished reading.
I know, I thought she was finished.
A&J Motors, Inc., Brian Duchac, DBA National Sales, P&T Auto Sales, Route 28 Motors Exchange.
Second.
Excuse me. Mike Penn. Do you have a motion?
Yes.
Second.
I second it.
Okay. On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Abstained.
Abstained?
Aye.
Motion carries. We have Class 3 license. Mrs. Manapelli?
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following Class 3 license to expire January 1st, 2018, subject to all regulatory department requirements. Brian Dushak, DBA National Sales.
Second.
We have a motion and a second.
I said second.
Discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous. Okay, we have automatic amusement devices, Mrs. Manapelli.
Mr. Chairman, I move to renew the following automatic amusement device license to expire January 1st, 2018, subject to all regulatory department requirements. Kitty's Restaurant.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Mrs. Manapelli, vote to schedule show cause hearing.
Mr. Chairman, I move to schedule a show cause hearing for the package store wine and malt beverage license for Pendleton Ventures, Inc., DBA, Tedeschi Food Shops, 202 North Street, on Monday, December 19th, 2016, at 8:15 p.m.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Mr. Gilberto.
Mr. Chairman, as I think has been well publicized over the past few months, there is a location in town to which a liquor license, a beer and wine license for retail sales has been issued for calendar year 2016 that no longer has its a lease at the location. Individual has come before the board on a couple of occasions with proposed transfers that have been denied. The individual asked to renew and submitted a letter to the board requesting to renew as well, while the individual looked for an additional location. However, after discussing with town council, it's our recommendation that the board schedule a show cause hearing to potentially cancel the license for not having a location to do business at.
Thank you.
Any questions? On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Ms. Manapelli, appointments and reappointments. State Ethics Liaison.
Mr. Chairman, I move to reappoint Barbara Statz as the State Ethics Commission Liaison for a term to expire on December 31st, 2017.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Next, treasurer for the term to expire on December 13th.
Mr. Chairman, I move
December 31st, yes. Mrs. Manapelli.
Mr. Chairman, I move to reappoint Mary Ann McKay as town treasurer for a term to expire on December 31st, 2017.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Next is Hillview Commission. Mrs. Manapelli.
Mr. Chairman, I move to place in nomination the following names for reappointment or appointment to the Hillview Commission for a term to expire on December 31st, 2019, with two openings. First, incumbent Peter Hemme. Second, incumbent Daniel Doherty. Third, William King. 4, Peter Antonuccio. 5, Vincent J. Rigucci III. 6, Rick Arrington. 7, Sean T. Delaney.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule.
Mr. Chairman, as liaison, I would be recommending to the board that we reappoint Peter Hemme and Daniel Doherty. Again, we appreciate everybody's interest in serving on the commission. These two gentlemen have worked very hard for a number of years. Again, Mr. Hemme is the current treasurer of the Hillview Commission. Mr. Doherty has extensive experience in the food service industry, and both of these gentlemen have worked very hard, particularly over the last year or two, in ensuring that we have a smooth transition with the vendor who's leasing the Hillview, with the transition there, and also the redoing of the pub kitchen, which has been an absolute nightmare. These two gentlemen have spent dozens and dozens and dozens of hours doing it, and they certainly deserve a reappointment, and I would strongly recommend their reappointment.
Okay, we will do a roll call vote. Each member votes for two. Are you prepared to keep a tally, Ms. Manapelli?
Sure. Yes.
Mr. Prisco.
Mr. Doherty, Mr. Hemme.
Mrs. Manapelli.
Mr. Doherty, Mr. Hemme.
Mr. Yule.
Mr. Doherty, Mr. Hemme.
Mr. O'Leary.
Mr. Hemme and Mr. Doherty.
Yeah, chair votes, Mr. Hemme, Mr. Doherty. I guess we really didn't need a roll call vote. Let me know when you're ready, Mr. Manapelli.
It's all for you to say.
Okay, moving along.
Next one is Conservation Commission.
Mr. Chairman, I move to place in nomination the following name for reappointment as member of the Conservation Commission for a term to expire on December 31st, 2019. One opening, Thomas Romeo, incumbent.
Second.
Second by Mr. O'Leary.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
I think this is going to be a landslide. They're not banging down the door to be serving on the Conservation Commission. Mr. Romeo, again, has served for a number of years in capacity as a member of the commission. Appreciate his service, and he's seeking reappointment, thank goodness. And I would urge the members to reappoint him.
Any other comments? On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous.
So unanimous, Mr. Romeo.
Yes.
No roll call for that one?
Board of Appeals.
Technically, it's a roll call.
We have, what, two openings, right? We'll do another roll call.
Whatever, I'm just...
If there's only one person, is it mandatory that we have a roll call?
No.
That's how it looks.
If there's only one...
I'm writing that we all stated Mr. Romeo's name, people. Mr. Chairman, Mr. Chairman, I move to place in nomination the following names for reappointment or appointment as members of the Board of Appeals for a term to expire on December 31st, 2019. There are two openings. One, incumbent James Peter Dimitri. Two, incumbent Paul O'Leary. Three, Amit Subramani. Four, Clancy D. Main.
Second. Mr. Chairman, just as liaison and also as a point of disclosure, again, my brother Paul O'Leary is seeking reappointment. He receives no remuneration for his service as a volunteer on this committee, so therefore there is no conflict in relation to any. And I can assure you there's no benefit being derived from this at all. Just like us serving here. Again, Mr. Chairman, I would recommend as liaison the reappointment of Mr. Dimitri and Mr. O'Leary, both long-serving members of the Board of Appeals, who contribute a significant amount of time, effort, and energy to their duties. And I would, again, thank the other two people for submitting their application for consideration.
Okay, so I guess we'll do a roll call vote. Start with Mr. Prisco.
Mr. Dimitri, Mr. O'Leary.
Mrs. Manapelli.
Mr. Dimitri, Mr. O'Leary.
Mr. Yule.
Mr. Dimitri and Mr. O'Leary.
Mr. O'Leary.
Mr. Dimitri and Mr. O'Leary.
And the chair votes Mr. Dimitri and Mr. O'Leary. Next. As soon as you're ready.
Mr. Chairman, I move to place in nomination the following names for reappointment as members of the Veterans Affairs Committee for a term to expire on December 31st, 2019. There are two openings. One, incumbent Joseph Arvino. Two, incumbent Kenneth Ravioli.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. In this case, there's two members and only two openings and no others. So I'll do it with a roll call vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous.
If I may, just for a second, I did want to say something in about the two. Both Joseph Jovino and Ken Ravioli put a lot of time into the Veterans Committee, and I just wanted to recognize them for their efforts in all the work that they do.
Next is the Forest Committee.
Mr. Chairman, I move to place in nomination the following name for reappointment as a member of the Forest Committee for a term to expire on December 31st, 2019. There are two openings. One, incumbent Scott A. Stimson.
Second.
Second by Mr. Yule. Yeah. On the motion, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. And I guess I'll make a point here to the public that there is an open position on the Forest Committee. If you're interested in being involved, you can go to the town website and fill out a application to be a member of a committee, or you can come to town hall and do the same thing.
Thank you.
That is it for appointments. Jane, are you waiting on anybody?
Yes. For reappointments?
Yes. One of them is library. I thought that was all set.
I've only heard from Steve and Jeff as far as reappointments go.
Okay.
So
I owe you. I will get that for the next meeting.
That would be great.
Anyone else?
And Kate and Mike.
Okay. Would the three of us commit to have ours to you for the next meeting?
Thank you.
Which is 2 weeks from today. Okay.
Definitely.
Thank you.
Excuse me.
Of course.
I would just cross that out.
Oh, it's all right. I'll just add my.
We're going to discuss the board meeting schedule. Mr. Gilberto.
Mr. Chairman, in response to your request and suggestion, we've put two items in the packet for tonight's meeting. The first is a listing of upcoming meeting agenda items, beginning with December and running into the month of June. And then the second listing on the next page is the proposed meeting schedule through 2017. Again, noting that we have a meeting scheduled on December 19th of 2016 and do not have meetings scheduled beyond that other than as prescribed in the board's policy, which is for the first and third Monday of each month. In the case of January, both of those Mondays are holidays, legal holidays, and the board is prohibited from holding meetings. So we have held here, per your direction, that the board would meet on the Tuesday of each of those weeks, Tuesday, January 3rd and Tuesday, January 17th. Monday, January 2nd being New Year's Day, the legal observation, and Monday, January 16th being Martin Luther King Jr. Day. And then going further along, you see in February 6th is the first Monday. We've left that on there as it usually is. February 21st will be a Tuesday. It is a Tuesday during the school vacation week. And then that following Saturday, the 25th, is a scheduled Saturday budget meeting for the Department of Public Works, Police, and Fire Departments. And the next change in the schedule is, that, again, the third Tuesday in April, April 17th being Patriots Day, the school vacation week. The proposal here is for a meeting on April 18th, per your direction. May 1st would be a first meeting in May, and then there would be a reorganization meeting after the election on May 2nd that would be held on May 4th. We've noted the May 8th meeting because it is the last possible date to vote on the budget and to sign the warrant. It is the second Tuesday, but we've noted it already in the budget schedule, so we thought we should flag it here. And then the regular third meeting is May 15th, town meeting being June 5th, June 19th being the third June, third Monday in June, excuse me. So hopefully that gives you just a bit of a flavor of what we have noted. You know, right now, from a scheduling standpoint, it will continue to be updated. We'll provide it in the packet along the way. But you do have a draft meeting schedule there, taking us about 6 months out.
Right. So it was my intent to try to put this meeting schedule together for the end of the fiscal year. And to begin to fill the various meeting dates with like a key topic that's important that needs to be addressed, and then other things to fill in to try to do a little better balancing of our meetings, and also give everybody an opportunity to look at the schedule and say, wait a minute, now, you know, I'm going on vacation on this particular meeting date, and you know, now that we're doing it way in advance, there's plenty of opportunity to reschedule the meeting for a different date. So I'd appreciate it if you look it over, and if you have any feedback, get it to Karen or myself or Michael, and we will make an adjustment and keep everyone up to date
Bob,
on the schedule.
I think
yes, Michael.
Bob?
Yeah,
I think Mike has a question.
Yes, Michael.
I think it's something I'd like you to consider is maybe potentially sometime in March or April, a special town meeting potentially. We may should at least thinking about it. Due to the J.T. Berry property, based on the path that's on, but I'm not sure where you can fit it in, but I think we should start thinking about it, since we're looking at schedules.
Good idea.
I think, Michael, when the committee is prepared to make a presentation to the board in terms of where you're going, I think it'll start to nail down the time frame.
Yeah, and I didn't notice that.
You're thinking in terms of timing, what month?
Yeah, easily the first meeting in January, or maybe even, I mean, the December 19th seems extremely busy. Not sure, but I think we would potentially be ready by the 19th, but I'm not sure. But definitely by the 3rd.
I think, you know, unless there's a negative impact on it, I would suggest that be done on the 3rd.
Okay.
But if it's time...
It's not a negative impact, not at all.
If it's time critical, then we move it up.
No, I think that's good.
And
Michael, you agree?
In terms
agree?
Of
the 3rd is probably the most realistic.
Associated with that, what are you thinking?
I'm thinking late March. Early April, but I'm not sure if there's something else in town that's being considered for anything that may fit in. You know, if we're going to do a special town meeting, if there's something else that we can incorporate into it, since we're going to be there.
My guess is there will be.
What's that?
My guess is that there would be something.
But I don't want to, you know, we could slow down one thing so we can get them both in line. You know, I think that's the respectful thing to do. But I would, you know, leave it up to.
You think the end of March would be okay? Not sooner.
I don't know about you, you know, the stuff you're working on. If you need another month, just let us know and we'll try to figure
that
out.
We'll let you know in a couple of weeks.
Yeah, that's good. Well, yeah. That's good. So that's the only two things I would say that we should just consider as we go through this.
All right, so in a couple of weeks when the athletic committee got some idea of what they're going to do.
We're meeting on Wednesday evening, the EDC, so I'll have a much better idea after that meeting. where we're going to be.
All the board members know that the bid documents are in Dropbox. Mm-hmm.
I read them with interest.
Any question about special town meeting? That could be held any day, correct? That doesn't have to be held by a Monday or Tuesday.
I think it's held on a Saturday.
Is that?
I
don't know.
Thing in the bylaw.
Yeah, we can. We considered it when we were doing the school project.
Yeah, I recall that. I don't think we're restricted to a Monday.
No.
Excuse me.
Michael, are you all okay with
the I've got the notes, discussion? Yeah, so we'll update it accordingly.
Okay.
Thank you.
Town administrator's report.
Bear with me just one moment, Mr. Chairman. Two items that I just noted in here. The first is pursuant to the board's vote at the tax classification hearing in November, the Department of Revenue has notified us that it's approved the fiscal year 2017 tax rate at $16.13 per $1,000 valuation. Secondly, I noted that the police department will be assessed by the Massachusetts Police Accreditation Commission for re-accreditation in January. There's a notice that was attached, and I just note that the dates were corrected, to read January 17th through the 19th. And that concludes my comments. Thank you.
I would just like to make a public comment regarding the efforts of the finance department, the assessor, to get all of the paperwork and everything in great order, get it approved so that the tax rate is approved in a very timely manner. So I'd like to thank them all for their efforts. Okay, board members, old and new business. Mr. O'Leary.
All set, Mr. Chairman. Excuse me, just one brief thing. I'm glad Mrs. Manupelli's home is still standing.
Oh.
And I'm sure she had an eventful holiday.
I was going to say thank you when I come to
Mr. Yule.
So how did that turkey taste?
It was cookies.
I got a couple interesting calls and something I've been thinking about anyway. And that's why I asked a question about the special town meeting. I would like for us to have some type of dialogue or discussion about moving town meeting to a Saturday. And the reason why I'm making this suggestion, it's not uncommon. I believe Reading does that. I believe they do theirs on...
No, Wilmington.
In Wilmington, I'm sorry.
Reading does not.
Right. I meant to say Wilmington. Thank you. I think the primary reason, my observation in the years that I have been on a town meeting, and more specifically since the new school, that seniors have not really... been able to attend because of the problem with it being at nighttime. And it really becomes, and I hate to use this word, but it is apropos, that it is discriminatory to have meetings at a time when a specific group of people cannot attend. And there are a lot of things that are going on in town that really impact the senior community. So this has a mind of its own. So I would like the board to seriously consider that. I know we've changed it to our town meeting from May till June, and that I believe was a good thing. But I think we need to seriously get the senior community back into the thick of things so that they can be part of the process. So again, I don't know if anybody has any thoughts on it, but that's something I think is a direction that we should start going.
Are you talking just about
For the special? Or are you talking about?
Well, I would consider it definitely for the special, but I'm also thinking for the regular town meetings as well. I think that's something that, I know we talked about it in the past, but, you know, this is a difficult thing for seniors, and, you know, the impact that the decisions that are being made have a greater impact sometimes on them than it does on those who are able to attend a meeting without any issues. So, you know, I'd like everybody to seriously consider that.
It might be a good idea to find out if we could get some public feedback on the suggestion prior to moving ahead with it. Just to arbitrarily make the change may impact other groups, right? So why not find some way of, maybe we can put a Survey Monkey out and, you know, advertise it, and maybe we'll get some feedback.
I think that's a good suggestion. The people that really need to answer that Survey Monkey are the seniors, and I don't know how much they are adept at doing
well,
that.
But we could also find some other mechanism for them.
Yeah, I mean, I think that would be a good idea. I think that's a step in the right direction.
I'm assuming that your concern over the seniors is more related to them having difficulty coming out at night, or is it some other reason?
Well, no. It's two reasons. A primary reason is the nighttime, okay? Because they as we get older, it's more difficult to see. Eyesight and driving for seniors, it covers more seniors than more that group than it would a anyone who's not a senior.
Yeah, okay, I
understand
that.
So it
but was there something beyond that?
Well, and then the cause and effect of that is that they don't get to be participate in the decision making of the town at town meetings. So they're excluded.
I understood that. I think maybe I misread you when you started this. It had something to do with, well, they're busy or they can't, you know, they can't get out on the evening. If it's related to driving, I understand.
Yeah,
I thought you were implying something else.
No. Okay. I mean, if they're doing something else in the evening and they choose not to come to a meeting, well, that's their choice. That's a choice that they could make.
Okay.
But they have to usually be driven to locations and so on. So, but I think it would be worth giving serious consideration.
Okay, anything else, Jim?
That's it.
Catherine.
Thank you, Northridge Fire Department, for coming to my home on the eve of Thanksgiving because of the grease fire caused by the use of an improper pan while cooking cookies. While taking cookies. Thank you for the informational session afterwards. And it was pretty funny, but they came right away. And thank you to my poor neighbors who heard all the alarms going off because my husband's compulsive, so we don't just tie into one alarm system. We have a secondary alarm system, and no one could shut them off. But anyway, they came right away, and I really appreciated it. They tried out some of the cookies that weren't burned in the grease fire, and also told me that a lot of people in the community had brought them plenty of things in Thanksgiving for them, too, so that was good. So I hope everyone had an enjoyable Thanksgiving. And
this excludes you from voting on their budget now.
Right, they told me they treat me the same as everyone else, and I said, that's good. Anyway, it was funny.
Anything else?
That's it. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yeah, I want to start off by thanking Jack Collins for his 20 years on the Hillview Commission. Sad to see that he submitted his letter of resignation, but 20 years, pretty good. Jack was a key member, and I consider him a friend, so he'll be missed. The tree lighting was wonderful. For those of you who didn't make it up there, it was fantastic. A little breezy, but very nice. And I love the new lights. And I want to thank the business community for stepping up in a big way. I think the cost was close to $10,000, and it was all said and done to install the electrical conduit and purchase the lights and have them installed. That was a very nice commitment they made to the community, and I want to thank them. And it looks beautiful out there. The play, the Oliver play at the high school. My daughter is a cast member, and I will tell you that was one of the best plays I've seen. The kids done such a great job on the set, the lighting, the sound, all run by the kids in the school. And it's just every year since we built that school, it becomes more and more impressive. And so I encourage folks to come out in the community to see it. It's Friday night is at 7 o'clock show, and Saturday is 4 o'clock show. And there's still tickets available, and you can purchase them online too to make it real easy. Or you can purchase them at the door. And Mr. Gilberto, I really I think I like the old look better now that I see you again. It's good to have you back.
That it, Michael?
That's it.
I attended the play at the school and with my wife and two grandkids, and we had a great time. And, I would just encourage, I know Mike's already said this, but I would encourage everyone that's listening to take the time out to go to one of the two remaining shows. It's well worth it to see the kids and see their hard work. And you can also, if you haven't been to the new Performing Arts Center on the high school, you have an opportunity to go there and see how nice that is, too.
Not a bad seat in the house.
That's correct.
Right?
Yeah. And your daughter, Michael, did a phenomenal job.
Thank you. She would impress me quite a bit, I got to tell you. She's the best son I have now. That's what I tell her. She's the Aphrodite in the play, and she really kills the. She kills it. She really. She embraced the role, and I'm so proud of her.
So we had a little snow today. I guess it's the kickoff of winter. Ask our commuters, our drivers, to when the roads are icy, to cut the speed down a little bit. Be safe.
I think the chief said there were three accidents tonight.
What?
The chief said earlier that there were three accidents tonight.
Oh, well, there were some. Usually the first storm is when people forget about it. They need to be retimed. So, anyway.
Get the scrapers in the car.
Just be safe. And we are meeting 2 weeks from today. Last meeting of the
19th
year.
Just as a side, Mr. Chairman, and thank you, Michael, for bringing that up, but Jack Collins' resignation of the Hillview Commission will cause us to have a joint meeting with the Hillview Commission for a joint appointment for the unexpired term. I'll check with Chairman George Stack and see if we can set it up for the 19th of December.
Michael, will you make a note of that?
Yep. I'll add it right in. But I'll let you know if that's going to happen. Otherwise, it'll be very early in January.
Right.
And again, Jack's a good friend and a good guy. Did a great job. I don't think there's a project up there that he didn't have his fingers in. So.
I served with Jack when I was on the Hillview Commission. You're right.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, that goes for all the members. They're running a business and they're spending time running the business. It's kind of invisible to everybody, but the Hillview continues to run. Revenue that they've generated in the form of capital expenditures to the benefit of the town, whether it's the park or the turf field or the parking lot up there. Or
Kid spot.
I mean, it just goes on and on and on.
We hope and that one, continues to go on.
And the kitchen, the pub is going to open at the beginning of the golf season. Is that what I hear?
Right. It's going to be open for functions only right now. What I understand, because obviously the winter time's slower, and then the intention is for golf season to have it open.
So with that, I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
I hear a second.
Second.
Second by Mr. O'Leary. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, Phil. Don't get